Hi everyone and Happy New Year! After a long holiday break, I am back with another mixed media project. I am starting a new journal on this book that is spiral binded. I like it because it has nice thick chipboard pages and it will give me enough space to be as dimensional as I want on each page. I will be using stone paper by Stamperia today. This is a very durable paper and you cannot tear it. I am going to demonstrate here. So, although you cannot tear it with your hands, you can always use your scissors or your paper trimmer and you can see it cuts perfectly. It is washable, it is paintable, and you can even use your sewing machine on it. And I believe that this is great for creating albums as well as covers for your art journal. I am going to show you a very cool technique on how you can create faux leather out of this stone paper. I am spraying water, a lot of it, on both sides, and now I'm going to make sure that I create as much creases as I can. I can be as rough as I want to this piece of paper because this is stone paper and I cannot tear it. Once I'm happy with the result, I am using my heat gun to make sure that my piece is nice and dry. And now I'm going to do some stenciling with my modeling paste. I am applying my modeling paste over the stencil with a spatula in random areas. And all the supplies that I'm using today are by Stamperia. And as always, you can find a full list of all the supplies that I'm using just below the video in the description area, as well as on my blog. Now that I have applied enough texture with stenciling, I am going to create the base color. For my base color, I am using acrylic paint. This is fluid acrylic paint by Stamperia, and this is the color of Sienna. I am applying it with my finger as well as a baby wipe, and I am going to add a slightly darker shade now, which is amber. I am going to apply it all over the project with a baby wipe. And notice how the modeling paste resists the paint and creates this nice texture effect. I am going to give it a quick try with my heat gun and then I will go ahead and use my sprays. These are Stamperia Aqua Color sprays and you can see the names of the colors that I am using on the screen right now. Both sprays are iridescent and this is going to make sure that it will add the shine that I need for that faux leather effect. After using this bronze one, I am going to introduce a turquoise one and I believe that they are the perfect combination together. I am totally in love with those two colors. If you follow my work, you know by now that I usually avoid sprays and that's just because they usually react with water when they are dry. But I found out that these particular sprays are permanent once they are dry and I'm just in love with them. And here is the final result of my faux leather and I just love this background. And just to make it even more interesting, I am going to stamp this text in random places on my background using brown ink. Make sure to check the close-up photos at the end of the video and you will see how much it looks like a real leather. Once I'm happy with the stamping on my background, I am going to use this brown ink pad and I'm going all around the edge of my paper just to make sure that I don't have any white edges. I am taking out one of the pages from my book and I will cover it with one pattern paper. I have this by Stamperia, which is a nice vintage map, and I am going to use my mixed media glue to cover the whole page. Now again I am working on stone paper, and I am blending a couple of colors with my fingers just to create a base for stamping my wings. Since I am planning to have the wings quite dimensional, using stone paper is going to make sure that the wings are going to stay as they are, although they are going to be in the front page. They are not going to tear or be vulnerable in any way. The stamp set that I am using is called Angel Wings, and they are by Stamperia. I am stamping both the wings by using brown ink, and now I will go ahead and use my scissors to cut them out. And you can see how easy it is to cut out stone paper, although you are not able to tear it off with your hands. Now I am going to add some highlights on both the wings using white acrylic paint with a very thin brush. I am just adding a few dots at the bottom of each feather. Highlighting the feathers are going to bring them more to life and they will not be as plain as they look at the moment. I am also going to use this metal label, and from the paper with the map I am deciding which part of it I want to use as the background for the metal tag. So I am using my scissors to cut out a piece exactly the size that I want to. And just to make this piece of paper shiny, I am going to apply some media gloss gel paste all over it with my brush. Before sticking my faux leather on top of my page, I went ahead and used my sewing machine to add some stitching. This adds a great texture on your background, and now I am ready to assemble everything on top. So I'm just playing around with all the elements to decide where everything is going to go, and once I am happy with the replacement, I am ready to commit with glue. I am using my knife to bring back the holes that I have covered up with my pattern paper. And now I am going to stick the faux leather piece on top of my page using some foam tape at the back. This is going to ensure that I have a little bit of dimension on my page. And I am also going to use my scissors to cut out the wing that goes outside of the page. And to make sure that my other wing stays a little bit popped up, I am using a piece of foam tape at the back. Now I am going to put back the page on the book, and I am going to work on some clusters on my page just to finish it off. I have all those paper tags by Stamperia, and I'm going to choose some of them to put here and there. I am going to spell travel by using these black stickers by Stamperia, and although I am placing them kind of random at this stage, I decided later on to write travel towards the bottom of my label. So here is the final result. I have also covered it up with some gloss gel paste to make it even glossier. And I am going to stick this key. This comes from a Stamperia key set with many metal keys. I secured the key on top of my label using some hot glue gun, and I have also added a metal compass that I happen to had in my stash. And that was my project for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. Here are some close-up photos of the project. Don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel already, make sure to do so, because this is the way to tell me that you love my videos and you want to see more. For more inspiration, click any of the two videos on screen right now. If you are watching from a mobile device, then you can find links to those videos just below in the description area, as well as on the info card that just popped on your screen. Thank you all for watching!